how my brothers and sisters, you know, what they could achieve and could have achieved, but they didn't stick with it. So I was just determined to change that kind of cycle in my family where they go to probably year 9, year 10 and drop out and then just, you know, hang around home and just meet up with their friends every day. And that wasn't my, that's what I didn't want to do. I wanted to do something with my life. You know, I used to watch rugby league and, you know, players like Ricky Walford and Jeff Hardy, you know, and, you know, all the Aboriginal players. And I was just thinking to myself, I'd love to be one of those footballers. I decided to come back another year to do year 12 again, just to play rugby league. I did that, and that year I played New South Wales schoolboys. We went away to Darwin, and I got homesick actually, and that's where I learned, you know, if I'm going to be away from home, I want to play rugby league. I can't get homesick. I've got to toughen up and really, you know, stick it out. We had a weekend off. I'd jump on a flight and fly home, and I'd get home. I enjoy it, and I didn't want to come back. But Dad pushed me out the door and he said, "Mate, you know, home's always going to be here. Nothing's going to change." When I played Australia, I played for Australia, played in Papua New Guinea, and he got to listen to that. And Mum said he was by the radio listening and all that. So, well, I got back and got a phone call, and heard Dad died. So I quickly jumped in the car and, you know, left what I was doing, jumped in the car, grabbed my brother who lived here in Redfern, grabbed him, met him, went home. I got in the drive home. I was just too tired and upset, so I fell asleep and got up there. And just like a part of my whole life's been, you know, like a person just been there has just, you know, just left like a big hole, and just feels like you're empty inside, but there's nothing can fill it. So I spent a lot of time, you know, just wondering, and couldn't make my mind up whether I wanted to play again or just give it up. And that's when I realized I was depressed, and it was just by coincidence that I went into the doctor and with a sore bump, I pulled me back out. And I went in, I had a spot, and I yarned to him, and he goes, and I just said to him, "Mate, is it just me? Because, you know, I'm arguing with my girlfriend a lot." He asked how I was, and he's a good family doctor. And he goes, "How are you?" And I said, "Mate, I'm all right." And he goes, "How are you feeling after football?" And I said, "Oh, great." And he goes, and he said, "How do you feel?" And I said, "Mate, honestly, I feel terrible. I don't know what to do, and I'm not getting any sleep." And he said to me, "You know, do you consider being depressed? And he goes, "Oh," I said, "What depression? What do you mean by that?" And he goes, "Well, are you sleeping?" Oh, I said, "No, I'm not." Are you know, worried about a lot of things, and do you feel down all the time, and you're never happy, you're always grumpy? And I said, "Yeah, well, that's me." He said, "Well, that's a sign of depression, you know, you're drinking a lot." And I said, "Yeah." And he goes, "You don't drink, because that adds to it." He put me on some tablets, which I took for the first batch that he gave me. I took, which really helped, because they really settled me down. I started to relax, you know. I felt like I was paranoid. I was just relaxed, and I did not even think about going to the. I go to the pub. I go in, do my footy tipping, and walk out. Wouldn't even look at the tab screen. Wouldn't even do any of that. And now I don't even go to the pub. I have a couple of beers at home at night after work or after training, and come home. But I just looked at that point where I looked at them guys drinking, and I thought, you know, when I was younger, I used to did not want to be like this, and now I'm turning into this.
We're just cruising around, isn't it?
Oh,
it's cold early.
You don't feel the cold
when you're playing football. No, you're down here.
The biggest mistake I made was bottling up my feelings after my dad died. And I used to bottle my feelings up before that. But the biggest, I found out that bottling up my feelings, you know, building a wall around me, not letting anyone talk to me, and, you know, not talking to anyone outside that wall, it really affected me, because it sort of caused me to be a different person, the person I'm not. You know, people will say to me, you know, "You're not the same person that you grew up." You know, I know there's got to be something wrong with you. And when people started to see that in me, I sort of thought, gee, maybe I'm not. So I started to speak to people. I spoke to my mum about, you know, the death of my dad, and I spoke to my girlfriend about it. Also spoke to a few of my mates about it, you know, about that. And I did let a few tears out, which is, you know, which is what you got to do. And I wasn't very confident about it, because I thought I would get judged about doing that. But at the end, I spoke to people who were going to help me, and I spoke to my family and some friends who I can trust, and I did trust them, and I felt so good, like a big weight's been left off my shoulders. And that's like depression. Like if you got something bottled up, especially with men these days, you know, they want to bottle everything up, because they think they're going to get judged by their peers or judged by their mates. They're going to bag him and sort of give him a lot of crap about it. But if he speaks to the right people, if you speak to the right people, they're there to help.
Oh,
I'd say go and speak to a doctor about how you feel. You know, a good family doctor or a good friend. A good family friend on how you feel. There are centres everywhere about it, about depression, Beyond Blue, you know, they're everywhere. So you get an opportunity to go out. If you feel it, see this video, you get out there, and if you feel the same way or if anything I'm saying relates to you, go and see a doctor, because they're there to help. That's why they're doctors. They're there to help and make your life better. They're there to make you better. And they can make you better. It's just a matter of time. It's just a matter of you making a few changes in your life where you've got to make a commitment in your life, where you've got to start living your life for you and your children and your family. And nothing else comes between that.